The data autofilter allows you to find and work with subsets of a database or a list in a quick and easy manner. It is useful in many situations, but extremely useful for data cleanup operations. In this clip, you will learn how to find and activate the feature and use the feature to find the data that matches your criteria. Here is a typical spreadsheet where the data autofilter can be used. Column A, we have the salesperson's code. We have the date on which sales were achieved. And we have the amount of sales for product A, B, and C generated by that salesperson. To activate the autofilter, you need to highlight the list that you want to apply the autofilter to. Click on Data, Filter, and then Autofilter. You will notice the little arrows appear in the top row. When you click on them, what it gives you is a number of options. In its simplest form, you can click on one of these. Let's say we'll look at salesperson 1, and you'll be given the subset of that list showing each time this SP001 is shown. To remove that, you can go back and say show me all. You can go to the date field and say, well, let's see what happened on the 1st of September. When you click on it, only the 1st of September's results will be shown. And again, if you want, you can click and say all. It's possible to actually combine your criteria. So we can say we want salesperson 002 and we'd like to know what happened on the 3rd of September. And only that will be shown. You can, if you want to, go back and say all. Otherwise, there's a quick way. You click on Data, Filter, and there's a Show All button. And that will show all the data again. You will have noticed that when you click on the arrow, there's one or two other options you can use. The top 10 option, when you click on it, gives you this menu. You can now say, do you want to see the top or the bottom? We're happy with the top. How many items do you want to see? Or it could be items or percent. In this case, we're happy with items. When you click OK, it shows you the top 10 items for product A sales. And in this way, you can pick up some trends with regards to the salesperson or maybe to the dates of the sales. Go back to the arrow and just show all. Another option is to click on the custom button, and this allows to customize what cells you're looking for. As you can see, if you click here, there's a number of options. So we can ask for all cells that are equal to a number, or that do not equal a number, can be greater than or greater than and equal to, less than and less than or equal to. For text, it's quite useful to look at words that begin with something or do not begin with it, end with it or do not end with it, or maybe they contain certain letters, certain key words, or do not contain it. For the purposes of this example, let's look for product A sales between 600 and 700. So we can say the product A sales must be greater than 600 and they must be less than 700. And when we click OK, only the items that match those criteria will be shown. You could, of course, have used the OR function. So if we go back to the OR situation and we customize, let's say we want to look for the extremes. So we want to say if this number is greater than, let's say, 900, or if it is less than 100, show me that list. And you'll see it brings up the list where the numbers are greater than 900 or less than 100. If we go back to the showing all the data, and we scroll down a bit, you'll see that we have a blank row here. Now in this example, we've only got one blank row. But in other situations, you may have many blank rows. What happens if you want to bring those up, maybe to delete them? You can click on one of the arrows. If you go right to the bottom, gives you the option to bring up all the blanks or the non-blanks. So if you click on blanks, all the blanks will be shown. You can quickly and easily highlight that row, delete it, and when you go back to the all situation, you'll see that your blanks have been removed. This is a very nice way of cleaning up your data. Just a word of warning, when you click on these arrows, you'll see that Excel has gone through the list and itemized the unique values so that you can search on them. However, it only goes through the first 1,000 rows or so for this section. So if your unique item is significantly down the list, or if it's a very large list, you may find that it's not listed here. So what you need to do there is go to the custom button and then search for it where it equals that number, and Excel will work through the entire list and find all the rows that match that criteria. If you want to remove the autofilter, it's as simple as going to Data, clicking on Filter, and switching off the autofilter, and you'll see the arrows will disappear.